You want answers?
I think I'm entitled to.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
So this is a wish. It's a very concrete wish that we invent this technology. If you gave me only one wish for the next 50 years, I can pick who's president, I can pick a vaccine, which is something I love.
And I don't want to go around insulting people. I don't want to paint with a broad brush. Every immigrant is this, every African American is that, every, you know, other person with, you know, different religious beliefs or whatever. You know, that's childish.
What do you think of Cory Booker's, and you didn't comment on him, and you feel free
to. Oh, I adore him.
What do you think about him saying kick them in the shins, essentially, start to get to that kind of political.
Well, that was Eric Holder.
Yeah, Eric Holder,
yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I know they all look alike.
No, they don't. Oh, well done.
It's all bullshit, folks. It's all bullshit, and it's bad for you.
In our world, there will be no emotions except fear, rage, triumph, and self-abasement.
I don't have to tell you things are bad. Everybody knows things are bad.
Bullshit is the glue that binds us as a nation.
Socialism and the dismantling of the country and no one's helped by this.
The sex instinct will be eradicated. We shall abolish the orgasm. There will be no loyalty except loyalty to the party.
This was the American way.
The new America.
It's like everything everywhere is going crazy, so we don't go out anymore. We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller, and all we say is, please, at least leave us alone in our living rooms. Let me have my toaster and my TV and my steel-belted radios, and I won't say anything. Just leave us alone. Well, I'm not going to leave you alone.
But we believe them because they're pounded into our heads from the time we're children. That's what they do with that kind of stuff. They put it in the heads of kids. They pound it in there because kids, they know kids are too young to be able to mount a sophisticated argument against these kind of ideas.
But always there will be the intoxication of power. Always, at every moment, there will be the thrill of victory, the sensation of trampling on an enemy who is helpless.
I want you to get mad. I don't want you to protest. I don't want you to riot. I don't want you to write to your congressman because I wouldn't know what to tell you to write. You've got to get mad. You've got to say, I'm a human being. God damn it. My life has value.
But if you see what I see, if you feel as I feel, and if you would seek as I seek, then I ask you to stand beside me.
I want all of you to get up out of your chairs. I want you to get up right now and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell, I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not going to take this anymore!
Kids, and up to a certain age, by the way, kids are going to believe everything a grown-up tells them. Everything. So kids never learn to question things. Nobody questions things in this country anymore.
We know the air is unfit to breathe and our food is unfit to eat. We sit watching our TVs while some local newscaster tells us that today we had 15 homicides and 63 violent crimes, as if that's the way it's supposed to be. We know things are bad, worse than bad. They're crazy.
Children should be taught to question everything, to question everything they read, everything they hear. Children should be taught to question authority.
The dollar buys a nickel's worth. Banks are going bust. Shopkeepers keep a gun under the counter. Punks are running wild in the street, and there's nobody anywhere who seems to know what to do, and there's no end to it.
But he left one final warning.
1984 is, I believe, a quite terrifying masterpiece. So terrifying, in fact, I don't think I should like to read another like it.
Parents never teach their children to question authority because parents are authority figures themselves and they don't want to undermine their own bullshit inside the household.
And the truth is, there is something terribly wrong with this country, isn't there?
There's just enough bullshit to hold things together in this country.
How did this happen? Who's to blame? If you're looking for the guilty, you need only look into a mirror. I know why you did it. I know you were afraid. Who wouldn't be? War, terror, disease. There were a myriad of problems which conspired to corrupt your reason and rob you of your common sense. Fear got the best of you.
Can't bear this hell! How am I gonna take this anymore?
I'm
tired
of hell!
I'm not absolutely dissatisfied with it. I think it is a good idea, but the execution would have been better if I had not been under the influence of TB when I wrote it.
Rage, triumph, and self-abasement.
You once claimed that you have an ability to face unpleasant facts.
Will be eradicated.
Is that what you've demonstrated in 1984 by drawing an accurate
portrait of the future?
There
will be no loyalty except loyalty to the party.
I think that allowing
always
the book being after all
there will be the intoxication.
Something like 1984 could.
Always, at every moment.
This is the direction the world is going in.
Thrill, victory, the sensation.
I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not going to take this anymore.
If you want a picture of the future, imagine a boot stamping on a human face forever. The moral to be drawn from this dangerous nightmare situation is a simple one. Don't let it happen. It depends on you.
So this is a wish. It's a very concrete wish that we invent this technology. If you gave me only one wish for the next 50 years, I can pick who's president, I can pick a vaccine, which is something I love,